God this day. Today is January 31st, 2021. For it is the day that the Lord has made. Praise God.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above the heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Dear most gracious God, Father, we are so thankful for your presence right where we are. For Father, there is no place that we will go where you would not be with us. So God, right now, we just ask that you prepare our hearts, Lord, to hear your word. Strengthen our faith, Lord. We welcome you into our presence right where we are. In the name of Jesus the Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Our call to worship. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem. For a day in thy courts is better than 1,000. I had rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in tents of wickedness. Because of the house of the Lord, our God, I will seek thy good. Those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. Blessed are they that dwell in thy house. Lord, I have loved thy habitation, the place where thy honor dwelleth. For the Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. O, sing unto the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. All the earth sings his praises. We ask that you enjoy the hymn of praise for this morning. We do not own the rights to the lyrics or the music, but God is in the midst of your praise.
Yeah.
And Lord, we ask that you renew in us your spirit. For Lord, we are only human, and we need you, God, for your guidance in our life. Father, we're so thankful for your hand of mercy, God, that you have kept us thus far. Lord, we are so grateful, God, that your hand is within our families and in our homes where we live. God, that your spirit goes with us wherever we go. And Lord, because of your great love for us, we will continue and can walk in faith, knowing that you hold us in the palm of your hand. Father, right now we just ask that you touch those that are in the hospital, those in the nursing home, those who are at home, Father, all those, God, in need of a healing touch from you. Lord, only you can heal. Only you can restore, Father. And Father, we are so thankful for your love and your healing within our hearts and within our homes. God, we are so thankful, Father, that you encourage us each and every day to look up to you, Father, in prayer, to seek out your guidance through your word, God. Oh, Father, we're so grateful for the Holy Spirit that speaks within us. For, Lord, we could not make it through this time without you. For, Lord, all other things have been put to the side. Those things that one used to rely on, God, has faltered and has died away. But, Lord, your promises are true. And your word is true, God. So, Lord, we will continue to hold on to your unchanging hand. We will continue, Father, to look up to you, God, for all of our needs. Lord, we ask and we pray, God, we're so thankful for your comfort and your love that you're showing on those that have lost loved ones. God, we ask that you be with them, Lord. Their loved ones have transition and are in your presence. And Lord, we're so thankful that you've given us eternal life. Lord, we ask that your mercy and your peace be with the friends and the loved ones of those who have transitioned over to the other side. God, that you would comfort their heart and their mind, Father. Lord, that you would hold them in the palm of your hand and cradle them, God, in your love, like a newborn baby. Father, that you would heal their heart. Their sorrows will rest in you, Lord, and in the hope, God, of your second coming. Lord, we ask that you touch our young people, our children that are in school, our school teachers. Touch our government, God. All those in authority, Father. Father, let your love and your patience rain down on our great church, Father. Oh God, over our bishops, lead them in your way, God. Lead your children, Father, the church body, in your way, God. Remind us not to take our eyes off you, Father, and place them on ourselves, but to look to you, God, at all times for all of our needs. Increase our faith, God. Give us hope, God, and your promises, Father. And Lord, we will do your will. We will obey your commandments, God. And we will follow after you. And God, with your strength, Father, the Holy Spirit, we will bring others into you, Father, so they can come to know you as their Lord and Savior. We thank you, God, for this day, for this hour, this moment that you have given us. In the name of Jesus the Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. What a wonderful salvation. Where we'll always see his face. What a perfect habitation. What a quiet resting place. Blessed quietness. Holy quietness, what assurance in my soul. On the stormy sea, he speaks peace communication with the Holy God is made through prayer. Our scripture reading will be coming from the fifth book of Psalms, 111, 1 through 10. And I'll be reading from the New International Version of the Bible. Praise the Lord! I will extol the Lord with all my heart in the council of the upright and in the assembly. Great are the works of the Lord. They are pondered by all who delight in them. Glorious and majestic are his deeds, and his righteousness endures forever. He has caused his wonders to be remembered. The Lord is gracious and compassionate. He provides food for those who fear him. He remembers his covenant forever. He has shown his people the power of his works, given them the lands of other nations. The works of his hands are faithful and just. All his precepts are trustworthy. They are established forever and ever, enacted in faithfulness and uprightness. He provided redemption for his people. He ordained his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. All who follow his precepts have good understanding. To him belongs eternal praise. The word of God for the people of God. From all that dwells below the skies, let the Creator's praise arise. From
Almighty God and my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to Pastor June Anderson Dorsey. the ministerial staff, to the officers, members, friends of Ralph Avenue African Methodist Episcopal Church, I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Most gracious Father, we come before you right now. Lord, we ask that you set Priscilla down and you stand up. Lord, let the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight. Oh Lord, you are my strength, my rock, and my redeemer. Amen. If you would go back to the fifth book with me of Psalms 111, I would start reading from verse 6. The scripture has already been read, but I'm going to read 6 through 10. And I'm reading from the CEB, the English Standard Version. He has shown his people the power of his works in giving them the inheritance of the nations. The works of his hands are faithful and just. All his precepts are trustworthy. They are established forever and ever, to be performed with faithfulness and uprightness. He sent redemption to his people. He has commanded his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. All those who practice it have good understanding. His praise endures forever. If you need a title this morning, it's trusting in the goodness of God. When a person of faith truly loves the Lord, they give their whole heart. As the psalmist said, I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart in the company of the congregation. God wants our wholehearted devotion. God has given us everything, and God expects us to reciprocate. The psalmist goes on to say that the Lord can be trusted. It's difficult to trust God when things don't appear to be going our way. It's hard to trust God when the world seems to be out of control. Our economy is on a downward spiral. Our former president didn't care if we was affected by a pandemic. And violence has affected our communities. It's hard to trust God when we have human trafficking in our societies and so much homelessness. In this psalm, we have an example of someone who trusts God, not because he fears God and his judgment. Instead, he trusts God because he has come to the point of knowing that God is good. Many people look at God, although they do not know him, and decide to fear him. This psalm teaches us that we can look at God and decide to trust him because he is good. Let's look at the advantages of trusting in the goodness of God. There are four examples of trusting God. God shows us four examples of his goodness, and they reveal to us what he is able to do for us. Number one, God displays his works, so we trust him by remembering his works. The Lord's works are great, studied by all who delight in him. Verse 2, when we see God's works, it is like a photo of God and what he does in our lives. The whole reason that God shows his works in nature is for us to wake up and realize that God is good. His wonderful acts are to be remembered. When it says here to write them down and remember them, the psalmist is referring to worship. Anytime you write what God does in your life, in a diary or some book or even a song, and you read it and remember it, you engage in worship. Worship tells God that I am remembering Him. Aren't you glad you're not an atheist? An atheist sees a beautiful sunrise and eats a delicious meal. But who does he thank? We who know the Father can praise Him for the works He has done. The fragrances we smell, the sights we see, the things that come our way benevolently are all reasons to praise God. God is so unfathomably good that there is no excuse not to worship Him. You do not have reason not to worship Him. You just have to remember what those reasons are. What works has God been doing in your life? Good question. Number two, God gives to us so we can trust Him to provide our needs and more. He has caused His work, wonderful works, to be remembered. The Lord is gracious and compassionate. Verse 4. We don't deserve it, therefore it is called the grace of God. But we certainly need it. That means we fall into God's compassion. This promise to provide for our needs and more are for Christians, those who fear Him. God remembers the covenant that He made with His people. Verse 5. He promised that He remembers the covenant in giving us a history with Him. That means that He saved you and bathed you in goodness. God remembers His covenant. We know that He remembers His covenant to us by watching His power in our lives. What has God done in your life that you didn't think could be done? 3, God inspires reverence so we can trust Him to make good on His promises. God inspires reverence, respect, admiration, and worship from His people. This is a good thing. God inspires awe, wonder, admiration, respect, and fear. It is the awe that we have when we say the word awesome. Our God is an awesome God. God is going to do great things in your life. Things that will inspire awe and reverence. But the very reason that God does them is so that you and me can trust Him. Look at all the ways in which God, just because of who He is, causes us to stand in awe. There are 5 awe-inspiring reasons to trust God. Number 1, His works contain truth and justice. Verse 7, God's works are stable. The acts of God are certain. God is not flimsy when He does something. When God brought the flood in Noah's time, it was a no. It was not a trickle. It was a torn around. That's what this verse means. With the word truth or veracity, it's established. God's works are clear. When a judge pronounces a judgment, you trust the word of the judge as it was law. The same is true with God. He is the eternal judge, and no one can contradict, object, or go against what He says. Yeah. This is a very good thing to know. Many people, things, and religions in this world do not have the same stability. Opinions, things fall apart, and religions do not answer all the questions that we ask. However, God has illustrated through all His works that He can be trusted. They are not lying. And more important, it can be tested. If you want to do things the right way, then trust in the Word of God. Start reading His Word in the Bible. It will surprise you. If you want to have a better marriage, then read Proverbs and the passages in the New Testament. If you want to worship God, then read the Psalms. If you want help in how to act right with other people, read the examples and bad examples in the minor prophets. If you want to know how to treat others and be treated, then read the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew. He has sent redemption, His Son, Jesus Christ. Over 2,000 years ago, He died for our sins. In fact, that God provided a way for us to have fellowship with Him forever through the sacrifice of His Son is the greatest act of love and compassion. This should make you think. When you think about the love of God and what He has given it, should inspire awe and respect for God. Number four, He has made a covenant, a promise, and He has said that it works forever. Yes. The fact that God provided a way for us to have fellowship with His Son, with Him forever through the sacrifice of His Son, is the greatest act and love and compassion. This should make you think. When you think about the love of God and what He has given, it should inspire awe and respect for God. He made a covenant, a promise, and He has said that it works forever. Have you ever had anyone tell you that they can keep a promise forever? I haven't. That is because we are not eternal. We may die, we may forget, but God alone can make a promise that lasts forever. Number five, His name is holy and awesome. God's name is awesome. He is terribly tremendous. When I was ordained, they attached a title in front of my name, Reverend Priscilla Taylor. This word shows the essence of this verse. It really is a misunderstanding because pastors and ministers are not to be reverent as much as God. God told Moses, take off the shoes of your feet because the ground you're standing on is holy ground. The ground was holy because God was there. In essence, we are to strip ourselves of everything that we are and come into the presence of God. It means we are to strip all of our pride, all of our posturing, all of our arrogance before God. We are but men and women. God is awesome. All of these awe-inspiring characteristics of God mean one simple thing for every Christian. Believe God when He makes His promise to you. Abraham had no idea how God would fulfill His promise because Abraham was not eternal. Many times we cannot see as far down the road as God. But when we have heard from God, or have read His Word, He makes a promise. You can bet that He will keep it.
Oh, yes.
You have to trust in the goodness of God.
Yes.
Start memorizing the promises in Scripture. Mm-hmm. This is one way for each and every one of us to trust God, to make good on His promises.
Yes.
God shares with us so we can trust Him to help us overcome our problems. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. All who follow His instructions have good insight. His praise endures forever. Verse 10. This verse is also the same verse that we found in Proverbs 1:7. Mm-hmm. Respect and obey the Lord. This is the first step to wisdom and good sense. God will always be respected. What is really amazing is that even though God is wearing awe and respect, He still wants to help us. He gives us practical wisdom, supernatural experience that can help us in every situation. Surely, the Lord God does nothing unless He reveals His secret to His servants and prophets. Amos 3:7. God gives answers to His servant. God answers to His children. If God is going to do something in your life, He will tell you. Therefore, you have to trust Him. He is not asking for blind trust. He is asking for active trust. You have a problem, ask God. He gives answers, and He gives these answers generously. If you need wisdom, if you want to know what God wants you to do, ask Him, and He will gladly tell you. He will not resent your asking. James 1:5. What answer can God give you to help you overcome your problem? Everybody has heard the story of the three little pigs. Mother pig sent them out. It was time for them to build their own houses. Pig number one built his house of straw. Pig number two built his house with sticks. Pig number three built his house out of bricks. Along came the wolf, who demanded entrance into their life, in their home. He wasn't invited or solicited. He just decided that's what he wanted to do. But John 10:10 says, the thief comes only to steal, kill, and destroy. But I came that you might have life,
yes,
and have it more abundantly.
Yes.
Not, pig number one said, not by the hair of my chinny chin chin. So the wolf puffed, and he blew the straw house down. Pig number one would have fallen, the world had fallen apart. So he hurried over to pig number two's house. The wolf followed. Ain't that how Satan do us? He's always knocking at our door. And he knocked on the door of the little pig. Little pig, let me in. Pig number two said, not by the hair of my chinny chin. So the wolf left the pup and blew his tail down. Pig one and pig two went off to number three's house. Now pig number three said, not by the hair of my chinny chin chin. So the wolf huffed, puffed, and blew. Many storybooks illustrate the wind blowing and hurling, and then cast forth out of the mouth of the wolf. You could see the strength he put into trying to blow down the house. But in the pages of the nursery rhyme, the pictures of the wolf showed him tired out. In fact, and the house was still standing. In fact, the wolf, after unsuccessfully trying to blow down the house, decided to change his strategy. But we know the devil don't have no new tricks. Mm-hmm. The old ones work well. Mm-hmm. And come down the chimney, he climbed up one side of the house and attempted to sneak in via the chimney, only to enter into a pot of hot boiling water. He shot right back up the chimney. When the story ended, the three pigs were sitting around the fireplace, with the big mad wolf looking outside, looking in. If you attach to your strong life, when stuff starts to blow, you're gonna crumble.
Yeah.
If you are attached to your stick existence, when stuff starts to shake, you're going to fall apart. But if you are part of a brick, unshakable kingdom, that has been built by Almighty God, I don't care what's falling apart around you. You won't be falling apart with it. If you are falling apart with it, you have not truly attached yourself to the unshakable kingdom. It is a kingdom that cannot be shaken. 1 Corinthians 3:11 says, "For no one can lay a foundation other than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ." So build on the unshakable kingdom, which is Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I extend to you the invitation of Christian discipleship. If you don't know Jesus in the pardon of your sin, pray this prayer with me. Jesus, I'm a sinner. I accept you into my heart. Please forgive me of my sins. I believe you are the Son of God, and that God raised you from the dead, and that you are sitting on the right hand of God, making intercession for me. Amen. Let us repeat what we believe. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the church universal, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Now may the grace of God, the love of Christ, the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide in our hearts forever. Amen.